For this edition of In the Club, we are truly going back to the beginning, where it all started for club sports, because we are starting with the club sports original sport and its most successful sport to date, men's lacrosse, with a pair of national championships in the last 6 years. And the man that we are about to bring to the microphones has been a part of all of it. He's been a part of the start, and he's been a part of the current. Jeff Guy, who is beginning his third season as the head coach for the men's lacrosse program in two different stints. He was head coach back in 2010-2011, and then he rose back to the top in 2019 after spending 5 years as the defensive coordinator. In between that time, he has amassed a total of 17 years of coaching lacrosse ever since he graduated after being a star lacrosse player in his own right. He's coached on the high school level here in the Phoenix area in Scottsdale at Notre Dame Prep and at Chaparral. He's also been a coach, assistant coach at the very prestigious Princeton men's lacrosse program. He's also been the head coach at the University of Dallas. Jeff Guy, for only 10 years on the college level, you've been a lot of places. What's the biggest difference between Jeff Guy, the coach of the Lopes program that was NCAA Division II in 2010-2011, and the Jeff Guy of 2020?
Well, I think the big difference is 10 years of experience, 10 years more experience. And at two different levels. So the NCAA Division I at Princeton, where we literally played at the highest level of lacrosse, not just college lacrosse, but of the world of lacrosse, 6 national championships in Princeton's history, and a host of All-Americans, Ivy League championships, things of that nature. And, you know, preparing every single week against the best, Johns Hopkins, Syracuse, Virginia, Penn, Yale. I mean, you name one of the top teams ever in lacrosse history, you know, we prepared and we played against those guys. Coaching under Chris Bates there at Princeton, who was the head coach of Princeton. Now he's the head coach of the new professional lacrosse league, the PLL Archers team, and coaching alongside assistant coach then Greg Raymond, who is now the head coach at NCAA Division I Hobart College in upstate New York. Being around those two guys, soaking up as much as I could, along with coaching, you know, some of the best players in the world, literally Tom Schreiber, 2-time professional league MVP now. He is probably the best lacrosse player in the world right now. Tyre Fiorito, who was the Ivy League player of the year as a goalie while I was there at Princeton. So I try to soak up as much as I can and instill some of the things that I learned along the way back into this program when I came back in the fall of 2014.
And when you came back as the defensive coordinator, which I'm sure was a little bit of a transition in itself, but you come back and all of a sudden you have unprecedented success for GCU. What was the secret sauce to that magic, being able to win national titles in 2015 and 2017?
Well, I think there's a lot of different components, obviously, but I think the main two components were, number one, Coach Rapkin and I had a very good working relationship, and we were able to sit down, analyze our strengths and weaknesses as a program and as a team, and trying to see one step at a time where we could take this program as we progress through the fall on trying to be one of the top teams in the MCLA. As soon as I came back on campus, we had the goal and the mindset of trying to win a national championship. Mm-hmm. And I think the part two of that is the senior class of that 2015 national championship team. That was their goal, that was their mindset, and they wanted to do everything in their power and everything that they could, and they were very hungry in order to do that.
You talk about the hunger, but I think anybody who has seen you coach on the sideline, they see the hunger, they see the fire. Now that you've kind of moved back up into the head coaching ranks from defensive coordinator, do you kind of approach that part of it differently, or is it still kind of the same Jeff Guy on the sideline?
My coaching philosophy is tell the truth. Tell the players the truth, no matter what. And I've learned, obviously, over the years, some guys you have to deal in certain situations differently than other guys. Some guys respond to that fire and your passion that you talk about, and some guys don't respond so much to it. So it's about taking the time to learn those things. And I think that fire and that passion obviously comes from internally within me, being passionate about the game, being passionate about coaching. But it's also something that comes from my father, who was the head football coach at my high school for 29 years, grew up around it ever since I can remember, being in his office, being on the sidelines, hanging out in the locker room with the guys. And matter of fact, he's still coaching high school football to this day in the state of Connecticut. I think he's entering like his 46th or 47th season.
Wow. Overall.
So, you know, I've been around it my whole life, and I think that's where definitely a lot of it comes from, for sure.
So since mid-March, I mean, lacrosse is such a competitive sport, especially in the MCLA. Everyone's looking for, you know, that extra edge and all of that. What have you been able to do with your players during the summer to kind of keep them fresh?
I'm also a certified strength conditioning specialist from the National Strength Conditioning Association. So we have a strength conditioning program that our guys are now in their second block and their second cycle in completing for the summer to get them ready, as well as some schematic things that I've been working on as I'm talking to some guys in my coach tree in the NCAA Division I, Division II, and Division III levels on things that we can improve our game in order to put our individual players into the situations that are going to make them the best that they can be and the best that we can be. And it takes time. It takes analysis. So what are the things that we did well during the season and analyzing the video and breaking it down? What are the things that we did not so well as a team and individually? And how can I utilize each individual player within our program that will build off their strengths and help us improve overall as a team?
As you can tell, he's the embodiment of, it doesn't matter whether it's 2 years or 17 years, Jeff Guy is always growing, he's always learning, he's always trying to move it on to his players, and that whets your appetite for this coming spring, where hopefully we don't have to worry about COVID-19, we don't have to worry about the shortening of the season, and lacrosse can go on as scheduled. You want to get involved and find out more about GCU lacrosse? There's Twitter and Instagram for both, men's and women's lacrosse. They each have a page on our website. There are all kinds of ways that you can find out what's going to go on at Prescott Field and the big GCU Stadium coming this spring. Jeff Guy, thanks so much for the time, and thank you for being a part of this edition of Into the Club. Until next time, I'm Jim Howell. We'll see you later.